Hey, all late but great. This is Jim here from Ohio, and I'm here to discuss this week's topic. This week, the topic was proposed by Tracy, and here it is. Tell a few of your coming out stories. Choose one that frightened you, one that turned out better than you expected, and one that did not turn out so well at all. How did you feel about coming out to people now that you've had to do it a few times versus the first few experiences? Well, as I said before in my other videos, coming out to my family was a breeze. It really was. And I wish I would have done it so many years before. It was really easy. They all of them were so loving and so accepting, and I think they knew something was up from the get-go since I was a little kid. I was just thinking about how this whole YouTube thing is so fantastic for younger people, because when I was growing up, we didn't have anything like this at all. Nothing. I wish I would have had this. I really, really do. I think that if I would have had it, I would have come out a long time ago, or a lot earlier. But it is what it is. You can't turn the clock back. But as far as being frightened about a coming out experience, I would probably have to say it would be with my mother. Although, as I told you, I told my sister prior, and she told my mother. So by the time we had our conversation, she had already known. But I was still shaking. And it just kills you. It really, really does that. We are put in this predicament to be nervous and sweaty and shaky just for being who we are. I mean, certainly no one chooses to be gay or chooses their sexual orientation. It's like saying, okay, I have red hair, so Mom, I got to tell you, I have red hair, basically is what it is. It's so intrinsic in our being, in our soul, that it's the same as having red hair or blue eyes or whatever. But I will tell you a funny coming out story that was really interesting to me. After I'd come out to my family, I started coming out to people at work. Well, of course, you know how work is. When you tell one person, then the other one tells the other one, then the other one tells the other one. And before you know it, our whole department at work knew that I was gay. And I would, I would pull one person aside and say, hey, I don't know if you heard this, but, I just wanted to let you know. I trust your friendship, but I just want to let you know that, I'm gay. And it was all wonderful, actually. I mean, nobody gave me a hard time. I think people actually respect you for telling the truth. But anyway, I got to tell you this one story. One day, this guy that I used to work with, I don't work with him anymore. His name was Mike. He was Italian. He was very good looking. I went to his wedding. I loved his wife. They had a little boy and everything. So one day, I think his car either broke down or something, and he needed a ride home. So I offered to give him a ride home, and he was very thankful. But I thought I'd give him the whole spiel. I said to him, hey, Mike, I don't know if you've heard, but I'm sure people have talked. And he said, yeah, he said, yeah, I know, I heard too. And he said to me, but I got something to tell you. And I said, what? He said, Jim, I'm gay too. I was like, oh my God, you're gay? I mean, I had no clue. I had no clue, none whatsoever. He was Italian, good looking, married, a new little boy, baby boy. So he started telling me about some experiences that he'd had with men, and he assured me that he was gay. He was not bisexual. So I was just like floored. I'm like, well, if he's gay, then how many other people are out there are gay? I mean, that was the whole thing to me. So it was really interesting. So this is back in like 1992, 93, something like that. So shortly after that, he got a divorce. He told his wife. He met another guy, and fast forward to 2011, they are still together, him and his boyfriend. And his wife actually remarried to another guy and had a little girl. So, wow, that was quite a thing for me to digest, because I never had a clue. I never did. So anyway, that's my funny sort of different coming out story that I thought I'd share with you. So anyway, that's about it, you guys. I mean, I'm pretty boring this week because, you know, my whole story is good. And I hope that if you are still in the closet, you do come out, because really, it's so much better to be yourself and to live and be who you are. So anyway, that's about it. Hope you guys have a good weekend. We're just going to rake leaves, I think, because all the snow's gone. It's actually going to be 75 degrees this weekend, I heard. So we got to rake up the leaves. So anyway, that's all. Love you guys, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.